All right, we're the Hebrew Israelites. Before we begin, we want to give all praises and glory and honor to Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, which are the true names of the Heavenly Father and His Son, who you ignorantly call Jesus Christ. We want to give a double honors to our instructors, our teachers, which are the apostles of Great Millstone. We want to give salutations and blessings to the sincere Akim out there feeding the sheep of Yahweh Shai throughout the four corners of the earth, in spirit and in truth. All right? We come out every week to prophesy and to teach and to rebuke and correct and to wake up the elect of the nation of Israel. All right, the nation of Israel consists of you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans. All right, the same people that you see listed on this sign. All right, you're the 12 tribes of Israel, meaning you're God's chosen people. All right, and we're living in the land of our captivity. And you didn't know America is Babylon the Great in the Bible, in the book of Revelation. This is the last captivity that the Israelites are going to go into, and they're going to be delivered out of that captivity. By way of our Lord, Yahweh Shai, who you even call Jesus Christ.
That's right.
But he's only going to deliver a remnant of us. He's not going to deliver the whole nation, because the whole nation is not pure in the eyes of the Lord. All right, you got the two-thirds of you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Natives that refuse to hearken unto the prophets of the Lord and according to his word. All right, we in serious times right now. We in the end, okay? All type of trouble and chaos is coming to the streets of America, man.
Right.
All right, nothing but evil is coming. All right, a day that you can never imagine, okay? And that's what we out here to do, is to prophesy and let you know before it happens. All right, that nothing good is coming. All right, and we gonna get it out the Bible. Go ahead.
This is Jeremiah 58:1. Cry aloud.
Isaiah.
That's Lachie.
Yeah,
Isaiah 58:1.
Uh-huh.
I said Jeremiah. I said, cry aloud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sins.
And that's ultimately what the prophets do. All right, they warn you of the judgment and the destruction that come to a specific empire or kingdom, but they also let the people, which will be the people of Israel, they usually let them know, hey, the Lord's getting ready to judge this place because you refuse to turn back and repent. All right? You need to get right with the Lord before he makes that judgment, that final judgment. All right? Because everybody's going to have to answer on the judgment day.
That's right.
All right? Whether all the things that you've done in the body, whether it's good or bad, and even the words that came out your mouth, it's all going to be answered in the judgment day of the Lord, man. All right? Read that again.
Isaiah chapter 58:1. Cry aloud, spare not.
Yeah, don't spare none of our people's feelings, man. All right, whoever you may be, we're not going to spare your feelings. We're going to tell you raw and uncut where you're going off. Okay? Wherever you're going off at, man. And we're talking about by way of the law of the Most High, the commandments. Okay? If you're an adulterer, you better stop sleeping with the next man's wife. If you're an adulteress, if you're a woman that's dealing with a man, you better stop being a slut and stay faithful to your man.
Right.
Or the Lord's going to deal with you in these last days, man. In this final judgment. All right? If you eat pork, shrimp, lobster, crab, you better cut that out and hearken unto the dietary law that the Lord had established for us.
Right.
So you don't defile your temple, because the Lord's going to destroy all temples that are defiled and unclean. All right? If you went to all wayward philosophies and all these different religions, and you worship these false idols and gods, you better stop doing that, or you're going to get caught up in this final destruction, this judgment. Okay? So that's part of us letting our people know, showing Jacob their transgression. All right? And we have to do that while we prophesy.
Right?
Because if you don't turn back from your sins, you will be judged. If you don't hearken unto the Lord's prophets, you will be destroyed. Thus saith the Bible.
Let me say this, if I may. It's not only telling you what you're doing wrong, but also showing you how to do right or not to do wrong. Also, we're not only out here just to say, hey, don't do that. We're also telling you what to do instead, the righteous thing to do also.
Yeah.
Instead of.
This is Proverbs 8 and 8. All the words of my mouth are in righteousness.
Yeah, talking about this word, man. This word is what's righteous. So follow after righteousness, man. All right? Not the Quran. All right? Not the Kabbalah. The Kabbalah. All right? The Egyptian Book of the Dead. None of those books. The textbooks in your universities. All right? No, follow the book of the word of the Most High, man. The book of the Lord. Go ahead.
All the words of my mouth are in righteousness. There is nothing froward or perverse in them.
Yeah, there's no lies in the word of the Most High. All right. He is a man that do not lie. Okay. And no lies of the truth. And this word is truth. All right. So when we come out here with the word of the Most High, we ain't speaking nothing but truth to you.
Right.
Because we're holding the word of God, who you even call God, which his name is Yahweh. All right?
There is nothing forward or perverse in them. They are plain to him that understandeth.
Yeah, meaning they're easy to be understood.
Yeah.
But that's if the Lord opened up your mind to understand, man. Okay?
And right to them that find knowledge.
That's right. To them that find up the knowledge, man. Okay? This word is the knowledge. These are the things that you must know. If you're an Israelite, a so-called Negro, Hispanic, or Native American, all right? You're supposed to know these things, man. You're supposed to know the laws, all right, what sin is. You're supposed to also know the Lord's prophecies, all right? You're supposed to know, because you've got to get prepared for what the Lord has in store for this kingdom.
If I may say the time, bro, because it's the truth, because it will come to pass, also because it's wise to know what's good, if you have the ability or have a power that will reveal a prophecy to you, you know, which only Yahweh Hashem Yahshua is able to do that. For us Israelites, that he has chosen to get it, he gives you, and it's wise for you to get these prophecies and to prepare spiritually for it in the best way you can for these prophecies.
That's right. You know, and ultimately this is going out to the elect, man. Whoever the elect may be, that's in the midst, man. All right, but if you're not of the elect, you're not gonna hearken. All right, we're just gonna be four Negroes out here with Bibles to your mind, man. All right, that's it, man. No, that's it. Go to Jeremiah 28.
All right, Jeremiah.
Because we don't have a positive, peaceful message to you people out here, man. All right, you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Natives, we ain't got nothing sweet out here for you, man. All right? The prophets of the Lord, they didn't speak peace to Israel. Okay? They came with a message that got them killed.
Yep.
Because Israel didn't like what they were hearing.
Even the Lord.
All right? Because Israel, they always want to remain in their comfort zone. Whatever they're doing at that point in time, that's where they're comfortable at. All
even
right?
Wickedness.
Even when it's wickedness. And they're at their most wicked point. Israel is at its most wicked point right now, man. All right?
History.
In history. All right? Our people are engulfed in the most bugged out, sick, twisted, perverted wickedness you can think of right now, man.
Right.
Why? Because they're under the vibration of this society, man.
Right.
And the vibration of society comes from the spiritual demon Satan.
Right.
So our people are really under the vibration of Satan right now, man. All right? How many men of our nation then crossed over to being women?
Oh,
are homosexuals? How many of our women are trying to be men?
Turning their kids over.
Turning their children over into a different gender. How much of that is going on amongst you tribes, man? So we got to prophesy against you, man. Along with this kingdom and the rulers of this kingdom.
That's right.
Which is the so-called white men. Who is Esau or Edom in the Bible. Go ahead, bro.
Jeremiah 28:8. The prophets that have been before me and before thee of old prophesied both against many countries.
Against many countries.
And against great kingdoms.
And against great kingdoms. Is not America a great kingdom? All right, do they not say that America is the greatest nation on the planet?
Which is a damn lie.
You know?
Wickedness.
That's what the first lady said recently, right? Hey, and according to prophecy, hey, Babylon is the great. All right? You know, that's why people have the pride of being an American.
First lady dude.
You know? Yeah, the first lady trans
dude. Lady dude.
Of the White House.
According to Joan Rivers.
You know?
That's what Joan Rivers said.
So we prophesying against this place, man. All right? We prophesying against that great city. All right? America, the greatest city in the world. The greatest country in the world.
You know this is a kingdom because who rules this kingdom? Because of whose face is on the money. Yeah. A king gets his face on the money. And who's on the money of America? The so-called white man.
Yeah. Go ahead.
It says, the prophets that have been before me and before thee of old prophesied both against many countries and against great kingdoms.
Yep.
Of war. And of evil.
Of evil.
And of pestilence.
And of pestilence, man. So those are the things that the prophets will speak about concerning the fall of a kingdom. That war was coming to that place. All right? Basically, like for instance, when Jeremiah prophesied against Babylon to Nebuchadnezzar, he pretty much told Nebuchadnezzar that your kingdom is going to get uprooted and that the Persians are going to come and take you over, man.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what ended up happening. The Medo-Persian Empire, they took Babylon down, okay?
And he even gave him the prophecies of what was going to happen to them, like to the end of time.
Yeah,
until
man.
We came and took the kingdom and ruled the earth again.
Yeah.
He gave the whole breakdown of the body and the four beasts.
Because he was prophesying against that Babylon, but he was also prophesying against this Babylon back in ancient Babylon, man.
Right.
And that's a mystery. But we're out here to reveal that, man.
That's right.
Through the power of the Lord, man.
Read verse 9. It says, the prophet which prophesied of peace, when the word of the prophet shall come to pass, then shall the prophet be known that the Lord hath truly sent him.
Yep. Basically, when the prophecy come to pass, then you're going to know that thou was surely a seer or a prophet that prophesied to you from the Lord.
Yep.
All right? So America being that last great empire, you don't think the Lord would have his prophets out, cussing people out, letting them know that the evil was coming?
Warning them, yeah.
Giving warning to them, cussing out their own people, the people of their nation, that the Father's getting ready to judge them because they refuse to turn back to righteousness. All right? Ain't nothing positive coming to America, man. All right? Y'all don't realize FEMA is translating so many different empty retail stores into concentration camps, man. What do you think that's for? Because they know it's going to be a high level chaotic event that's going to take place in America where they're going to have to control the people. And there's going to be certain people that they won't know resistance from. So what they're going to have to do is they're going to have to make insurrection upon the people who they fear would be a threat to the world order, so they can basically take these people and put them in those detention centers to interrogate them, man.
And they're gonna rule you by fear.
Okay.
That's what they're ultimately gonna do, man. That's why they have what you call order of chaos, which means order out of chaos, man. Okay? They're gonna establish order out of a chaotic event. Okay? All these different false flag terrorist attacks, it's all set up by your government. Okay?
Shootings.
A lot of these shootings that's happening, it's all staged, man. Okay? Because they're brewing for something.
Diverting attention.
All right? That's what they're getting ready for, man. And it's the agenda of the elites, which you people are in the dark about, man.
You know, if I may, bro, you know, you've heard of the word Illuminati and the Masonic orders and all of that, but you don't truly understand about the 13 Bacon families that break down and their agenda, written in the Georgia Guidestones. You don't fully understand what their agenda is about. Well, the Bible has it, the blueprint of their agenda.
Yep.
And then they're out there putting the messages out there because the World Wide Web is spilling the beans.
Okay.
That's right, man. You know? And your pastor he's not going to tell you that, man. Nor is he going to show you out of the Bible. All right?
Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 17. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
Another name for a watchman is a prophet or a seer.
Right.
Okay? A watchman is somebody that stands on a tower and he looks out for any threat that may oppose the actual establishment or kingdom. Okay? We're here to warn you of the sword that's coming, man. And the Heavenly Father's gonna use this white man to come down upon your people, man.
That's right.
Through way of the UN troops, his military, which are gonna be foreign, all right? And an hour of martial law, man.
Yeah.
They got a lot of, down there in the South, they got a lot of SUV vehicles that are tinted and bulletproof. And they're all lined up around these different empty retail stores, like Walmart, for example. All right, and they have a tank station with barbed wire fences outside of those different Walmarts, man. Because they're getting ready to turn those empty Walmarts into concentration camps. All right, detention centers.
And then you got those all right. coffins, too.
They got the coffins down there. So the elites, they're ready for you people, man. So you people remain in the dark and wait for this devil to come down with great wrath on you, man.
Right.
Don't say that you ain't never heard it from the prophets, man.
And lo, it will come. Though it tarry, wait for it.
Come.
Because it will not tarry.
That's right. All right?
It's a little more.
So, yeah.
Verse 17, Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, hear the word at my mouth, which is where his mouth.
Yeah, hear the word at the Lord's mouth. All right, we're speaking the word of the Lord, man. So hearken up. Go ahead.
It says, and give them warning from me.
So we're supposed to give our people, Israel, we're supposed to give them warning from the Heavenly Father. What he's getting ready to do to this place, man. All the events that's about to lead up to the second coming of our Lord. All right? How he's coming back. We're supposed to prepare you for these things, man. The only way to do that is through teaching you and prophesying out of the word of the Heavenly Father, out of the Bible.
Right.
No other way.
Because what we're warning you is to get spiritually right. How do you get spiritually right? By doing, following the best of your abilities of these statutes, laws, and commandments in the Bible, but through faith. You know, you got to do it through faith, but also you have to, through faith, watch out for these prophecies and be prepared for these prophecies. That's the most important part, having faith and being prepared for these prophecies. Knowing his name, knowing who you are, and knowing that he may have mercy on you, but he probably won't. But these events will happen. But you gotta be prepared, and if you are granted salvation, then you'll be all right in those said coming days. But it takes an act of doing in faith. So take heed to the warning of that.
Just in the demonic period too, right now.
Yep, and it's in the time period now, right.
Yep, that's right.
Good on that.
You have something?
Ezekiel 33 and 33.
Go ahead.
This is Ezekiel 33 and 33. And when this cometh to pass, lo, it will come.
It's talking about the Lord's prophecies, man. Spoken of in the Bible.
I'm gonna go up to 31.
Yeah, go ahead.
This is Ezekiel 33 and 31. And they come unto thee as the people coming, and they sit before thee as my people.
Yeah, this is talking about when our people, when they hear the word being preached, and they come up before us, go ahead.
And they sit before thee as my people, uh-huh. And they hear thy words.
And they hear us preaching the word, they hear the prophecies coming out, go ahead.
But they will not do them.
They will not do after what the Lord said, okay? What did the Lord say? And get, I think it's Matthew the 4th chapter and the 4th verse. All right, let's hear who the world even called Jesus Christ had to say, man. Because it's one thing to hear us preaching his word, but now you got to take responsibility once you hear the word coming up. Now you got to count the cost.
Matthew 4, verse 4, it says, but he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of the Most High God.
So you got to live according to the word, man. All right, this word is what gives you everlasting life, man.
Right.
Okay? So hearken unto to this word if you want to receive everlasting life, man.
Right.
Which comes with salvation. All right? That's it. All right, go back.
This is Ezekiel 33 and 31. And they hear thy words, but they will not do them.
Yeah, you're supposed to be a doer of the word and not just a hearer only. Okay? Go ahead.
For with their mouth they show much love.
Yeah, you're going to have some people, they going to say, hey, they're going to throw up the fist when they hear us teaching. Hey, keep preaching. Keep doing the right thing. Amen. That's right, brother. You know, cheerleading, you know? The men of the Lord, they didn't need cheerleaders to preach the word, man. They were strictly about business, getting the word out, man. And those same set men, they feared the Lord. That's why they went out and they prophesied, man. And they wasn't afraid of the people, even though they knew that the same people that would hear the word coming out would get offended. They would want to put the prophets to death. A lot of people are not going to like what we out here saying. And it proves itself every time. But we going to prophesy anyway.
Nearly every time.
That's right. Go ahead.
For with their mouth they show much love.
Go ahead.
But their heart goeth after covetousness.
Yeah, but their mind is focused on the things of this world. Are you focused on the NFL season? Or are you focused on whatever entertainment that's going on in Hollywood right now? Bunch of folly, stuff that don't mean nothing, man. This world's getting ready to pass away, man.
That's right.
We're not saying don't entertain yourself or find a form of entertainment, but that should be the number one focus in your life. The number one focus in your life should be doing this word so you can obtain salvation. That should be the number one focus in your life. Yeah, do you go to the movies and watch comedies at the house and Netflix every once in a while? Yeah, of course. But the number one focus in your life should be this word. You're trying to live to the very best of your ability to seek salvation from the Heavenly Father. Right, exactly right, bro. Don't idolize the championship trophy or the WNBA trophy or whatever else.
I got to preach. This is 1 Corinthians 7 and 31. And they that use this world as not abusing it.
Yeah, use this world as not abusing it, all right? Doing what you need to do to get through life and sustain yourself, man. There's nothing wrong with that, all right? We first of all, we in captivity, so we got to work, all right? We got to pay bills and be subject to payments. But don't let this world get the best of you, man. All right?
Don't get caught up in it.
Don't get caught up in it, man. The affairs of this life. All right? Everything that's a part of this world is nothing but wickedness, man. All right? All they teach you is sin. Ways that's contrary to the Heavenly Father.
That distraction.
You know? That's what they teach you in this society, man. All right? The biggest thing right now is you got to accept all manner of wickedness, man. You gotta be down with the homosexuals, the transgenders, you know? If a man makes a sex change and he gets with a woman who became a man and they have children, you gotta accept that. That's the type of world we living in right now, man.
This world.
Alright, if you at a party or something like that, and you dancing with a chick, But you might not realize that's a dude. But you're supposed to accept that. That's what this society is teaching you, man.
Right. It's only dancing. It ain't only dancing. Anybody that really dances, you know, with a person knows it ain't just dancing.
No, man.
There's a connection that happens.
Yeah.
Kind of, this world's so wicked. When you point out a faggot or a transgender, they look at you like something wrong with you.
Right.
Yep. Because they didn't shift the standard of man to oppose the natural order that the Lord set up.
Good is evil, evil is
okay.
good.
The Lord, the powers that be right now, they didn't flip good to mean evil and evil to mean good.
Yeah.
Okay, and it's a battle right now. All right, it's a battle between the godly and the ungodly. And that's the duality of the Heavenly Father, man. I think that's in Apocrypha. I want to say it's the 33rd chapter. All right, right now this is we're in a part of a spiritual battle, man. We're in the middle of a spiritual battle. All right. The good is set against evil.
Let's start right there. That's where we start at 14.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sirach chapter, the book of Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha, chapter 33, verse 14, said good is set against evil.
Yeah, in these last days, good is set against evil. All right? Good is set against evil. And that's what you're seeing before you, man. The righteous versus the wicked. And right now, unrighteousness and evil outnumbers or outweighs the righteousness right now, man.
Right.
The godly. All right? The godly is outnumbered by the ungodly, man. That's why we're being persecuted, man. The men that's speaking uprightly. That's why this devil got to come with laws to censor us, man. You know? It's gonna be a point in time where we trying to push this word, and we doing it through the internet, and you got YouTube that's putting together laws to start taking down channels with brothers pushing out the word, man.
They taking down.
They got the internet. Just got turned over to the UN.
They're about to have the UN
this
take
month,
over
yesterday.
Of the internet.
Yesterday, it got official.
Man. And guess who signed that? Obama signed that, man.
Yep.
Some organization called I Can.
Yeah.
But yes, I can.
Right.
You know, with yes, we can, right?
Right.
The corporation is I C A N N.
Good. Yep.
And with the YouTube, YouTube came up with a new program.
The heroes.
Yeah, the YouTube Heroes. The new program is called YouTube Heroes, and it could take you could have anybody. Anybody that want to do it, they can become a part of the YouTube Heroes, and through that YouTube Heroes, you rank up depending on how much of a menace you are.
Yeah.
It was created for us.
Yeah, to flag all our videos.
To flag all our videos and to mass flag our videos. Yeah. And you rank up with the destruction that you're doing to the flag.
And let me say this, now, the funny part about it, because they know they can't hire 20 or so people to just go on there and go through all the really great millstone videos. We have videos, we like roaches, man, like Bebe's kids, man. We just everywhere. We just multiplying pages upon pages, videos upon videos. We spread the brother's video from here to this page, to this country, and you know, on and on and on. But if they can let all the people get involved, they might have a chance to kind of chop it down.
Come, but when that's happened, and the Most High allowed it to happen, then that's famine of the word.
Yep.
That's right. That's right. But
until then,
you ain't gonna stop the word coming out, man.
Right.
We gonna, hey, y'all start taking our channels down. 4, 5, 6 channels gonna go up at a time, man. We went through that years ago, man.
Right.
It never stopped a damn thing. And more brothers through that course of time when they was shutting down our old channels, more and more brothers then heard the word, and more camps start springing up through that, man. That's why you got brothers, and you got a brother that woke up in Guyana, you got a GMS Guyana, you got a GMS Mexico, We got brothers all up in Europe, all over Europe,
Canada.
The Caribbean islands, man. So this word is being heard all over the world, man.
Via the internet.
And that's how you know that we in the end.
All
right. Go back to where you was at, brother.
This is Ezekiel 33 and 32. Go back in 31. And this is Ezekiel
33. You finish that part. You gonna go back to that.
Ecclesiastes. Chapter 33.
Well, number the prince of the air messing with us.
Chapter 33, verse 14. Good is set against evil, and life against death.
Yeah. Good is set against evil, and life is set against death. Okay? And that's what's happening right now, man. A lot of people that's alive right now, they're living a life either to live or to die.
Yep.
The ones that's living a life to live are seeking after righteousness.
They're
seeking after the ways of the Lord, man. All right, they're seeking after everlasting life. Those that are seeking after death are into the ways of the world, the wickedness of this world, man. Being a homo, being a faggot, being a slut, an adulterer, worshiping these false gods and these false religions.
Celebrate these holidays.
Celebrate these pagan wicked holidays.
Okay.
Like the holiday that you about to celebrate at the end of this month, which is nothing but a satanic holiday, man.
Right.
Ain't nothing holy about that day, man.
And you know that, hey. When has Halloween ever been anything of God or anything positive? Everybody knows it's all scary and masks, and then you want to make it all cool because there's jack-o'-lanterns and candy and costumes. But that was all set up in a ritual of wickedness, of sacrifices.
Yep.
Let me keep reading. It says, so is the godly against the sinner, and the sinner against the godly.
And that's also what you see, man. The righteous standing boldly against the sinners. Okay? The sinners are those of our people that are not hearkening unto the Lord, man. That are not keeping the Lord's commandments to the best of their ability. The ones that still want to be wicked, that want to be niggas and spicks and bow and arrow drunk natives, all right? They don't want to change their ways and become men and daughters of the Lord, okay? That's who that's talking about, man. There's a fight, there's a battle between the two, man. The ungodly versus the godly, man. The ones who uphold this wicked lifestyle in this world versus the ones who's upholding the words of the Heavenly Father
in
righteousness. All right? And that's what you see, man. Okay? The battle of the forces, the angels and the demons. Okay? That's what we're up against, man. All right?
One more, it says, so look upon all the works of the Most High, and there are two and two, one against another.
Yeah, meaning balance. Okay, everything with the Lord is a duality, man. Everything is a opposing force within each other, man. All right? And in this time, only the elect will be considered the godly. The rest of the people are ungodly.
Right.
All right? Back during the time of Noah, it was only a few souls that was righteous compared to the rest of the world.
Eight versus the rest of the world.
You know? So how much more now, man? And that seed of wickedness that was sown since then has grown. All right? So it's a lot worse and more evil and wicked in this day and age than it was back during the time of Noah.
God.
Okay? The majority of you people, you represent those people that were outside of the ark.
Right.
And you weren't able to get in. Okay? Because you decided to stick around and party and be a wicked soul against the Creator, man.
Didn't think it was gonna rain.
And you didn't think that judgment was coming. All right, it's the same thing today.
All right?
So now is the time to choose between whether you're gonna, whether you want life or death.
So gotta choose, or be chosen. No,
because really, the elect are already chosen. It's already chosen for the elect to choose to have life, man. All right? So that's it on that. Let's go back.
It's Ezekiel 33 and 31. And they come unto thee as the people coming, and they sit before thee as my people.
Yep.
And they hear thy words, but they will not do them.
Yeah, they hear the word coming out, but they don't never take action with it, man. It's just something to listen to, and it sounds good for a moment. Or it sounds interesting, you know? But it doesn't strike a chord with their spirit. All right? That's the majority of you people out here, man. The ones that it strike a chord with, hey, they gonna come out consistently and they gonna hear the word, man. And then eventually, they gonna become a doer of the word. And they gonna start doing what the men of the Lord that's teaching the word is doing. All right? Go ahead.
But they will not do them. For with their mouth they show much love, but their heart goeth after covetousness.
Yeah, but they, at the end of the day, they still gotta get up the street and go in and get them some crab legs or, you know, some shrimp, you know. Go sightseeing, go drink. They gotta go get their nut off. All right, that's more important. Okay? Keep your head up your woman's ass. That's more important than hearing the word of the Lord. Go ahead.
But their heart goeth after covetousness.
Yep.
And lo, thou art unto them as a very lovely song of one that hath a pleasant voice and can play well on an instrument.
Yeah, because it pretty much sounds entertaining to you. Okay? Just like you take everything else entertaining. All right? But this ain't no sideshow up here, man.
Good.
All right? This is life and death up here. Okay? This is salvation or condemnation.
That's right.
This has nothing to do with entertainment up here, man. This not no sideshow. We ain't out here with buckets.
Asking for money.
All right? We do this free of charge, man. Because we'd rather store up our treasures in heaven. All right? But it's going to backfire on you. If you take this as a joke, it's going to backfire on you. Because the words that we're speaking unto you, when you actually see it come to pass, it's going to be too late for you. And that's your ass. Okay? And it ain't going to be an inquisition. Okay, you can't plead with the Lord in that day, man. No rebuttals, no nothing, man.
No excuses.
Okay?
No sidebars.
Go ahead.
For they hear thy words, but they do not them, but they do them not.
Yeah, they do them not. All right? They can hear us all day long preaching this word, telling them what they should be doing and what they should be doing.
And they know it's right,
but at the end of the day, they refuse to come into the light because they don't want their deeds to be reproved. Okay? You don't want to change your ways. You want to stay a nigga in America. You want to stay a slut in America. Okay?
You want to try to mingle the wisdom of the world and the wisdom of the spirituality of Yahweh Hashem. You want to mix them together while you're in the world. And it don't mix. Oil and water don't mix.
Right, man. That's it.
And when this cometh to pass, Lord will come. Then shall they know that a prophet hath been among them.
That's right, man. That's how you're gonna know. It's gonna be confirmed the moment these events happen, man. Okay? When you look outside your door and you see tanks and SUVs with dark glass, all right? When you see sharpshooters, you see UN troops patrolling the streets and roadblocks and curfews nationwide, that's when you're gonna know. When you see people getting taken out of their houses forcefully and women getting raped, all right? Children being snatched up, all right? People dying left and right. When you see people dropping dead by the newest pestilence, That's when you're gonna know. All right? That's it, old man. You right down to second interest 15? Yeah, get second interest 15.
Come, start to talk.
Come.
This is second interest 15. Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people.
Read a little louder.
This is second interest 15 and 1. Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy.
Yeah, and that's exactly what we're doing. We're speaking the words of prophecy, man, to our people. Not you white people.
That's
man.
Right.
You're not the people of the Lord. You're the devil.
That's
the
right.
Bible speaks of. We're prophesying against you. All right? Your kingdom is up. America is getting ready to go down.
Right.
All right? There will be no more rule from you devils, man. Right. You didn't have your share. All right? We seen what you didn't deal with the earth under your rule.
Right.
Now it's time to give the earth back.
Hey, look around. It's lucky, bro. Look around and see what the deeds that you did upon the earth are. Look how messed up the planet is. It's all effed up. It's all in dire straits. There's war and outcry everywhere. Injustice everywhere. This is what happens under your control. And you like it this way. And worse, look, people don't even know what gender they want to be. If they had, like, as if they had a choice.
Behold, speak down the ears of my people the words of prophecy,
yep.
Which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Most High.
Go ahead.
And cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true.
Yeah, these prophecies are faithful and they're true. Okay, meaning they're going to come to pass, man. All right? No word of this book is going to fail. All right? Read that part again.
This is 2 Edges 15 and 2. And cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true.
That's right, they're faithful and true. That's why they're written in the Bible. Okay, that's how we got the Bible. All right, the prophets, they received the word from the Heavenly Father, and they wrote it down and they published it. That's how we got the Bible, all right? So we're speaking the words of the Lord. Isaiah 55 and 6.
Isaiah 55 and 11. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please.
So whatever the Lord said is going to be accomplished. Okay, because he's not a man that he should lie. Okay? So whatever he said is going to happen. So we're prophesying about America. What's going to happen to America, man? And nothing good is coming to this place, man.
Come.
All right? America is through.
Right.
Babylon is out of here, man.
So, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it.
That's right. Go back.
This is 2 Edges 15 and 3. Fear not the imaginations against thee. Let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee.
Yeah, the incredulity of the people that speak against the prophets, or the people that don't believe what the prophets are saying. We don't fear that. We don't care about that, man. Because the Lord told Ezekiel, speak this word whether they hear or forbear. And that's referring to the you wicked Israelites. You hard-headed, stiff-necked, you tribes, man. Okay? Because you're going to be hard-headed. You ain't going to want to listen. You want to do your own thing, man. You want to go after your own lust of your own flesh. Okay? The lust, the satisfying of your flesh is more important than hearkening unto the Lord, man.
Right.
That's, it always been that way. And that's the reason why the Lord always sent Israel into captivity and slavery, man. All right? Go ahead.
For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness.
Yeah, all the unfaithful are going to die in their unfaithfulness, man. Our people that don't have faith, they're going to be destroyed because of their lack of belief in the Heavenly Father and in His Son. All right? They don't confess the name of Yahweh and Yahweh Shai. Okay, they don't believe the full doctrine, 100% truth. They don't hearken unto the prophecies. They hearken unto to heresies. All right, so they're unfaithful, man. They take heed to seducing spirits that lead them out of the way in error, away from the truth. They're all gonna die in their unfaithfulness, man. Even the men that hold this Bible and fall off, you're gonna die in your unfaithfulness.
For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. Behold, saith the Most High, I will bring plagues upon the world.
So the Lord said he's gonna bring plagues upon the world. So he's gonna plague this place. All right, it's gonna be so much different torments and terrors. You're not gonna know from this it cometh. Like it says in Isaiah, the 47th chapter, man. Okay? It's just gonna be happening constantly, man. Back to back. Different deadly diseases, biological warfare, and it's all gonna be coming from this damn devil. But the Lord gave the power to this devil to bring it upon you people, man, for judgment's sake. All right, what they create in these laboratories, like the CDC, the Center for Disease Control, they control all that, man. All right, they create the diseases as experiments, and they spread them among the people. And they use that as a means to quarantine and control regions of the earth.
And all these diseases are patented.
Yeah, that's how you know that they could create them and control them.
Kind.
Yeah, patent is really like a receipt.
Yeah.
Or the recipe.
Yeah.
You
know? Yeah.
That's it.
Saying that they got the receipt on the recipe, that they bought all the ingredients and put it together.
Huh. It's like a copyright.
Right.
Yeah. Go ahead.
I think it was the Rothschild just bought the Zika virus.
Yep.
Got the patent on Zika virus.
Patent on the Zika, yep.
One of them Rothschilds.
This is 2 Edges 15:5. Behold, saith the Most High, I will bring plagues upon the world. The sword.
The sword. So that's another thing that's coming on this world, man. The sword, man. Our killing instruments. That means a lot of people worldwide are gonna die by the hand of the sword. And the main man that's holding that sword is the so-called white man. Okay? And he brings his warfare by any means. Okay? Diseases. All right? The chemtrails, that's a form of the sword. Yep.
Killing instrument. Mainly the sword is just a killing instrument.
Yeah.
The so-called white man has mastered all levels of destruction and perdition.
Yep.
And of killing.
Yep.
Whether it be in your water and the air and the food. From malnourishment, from the medical field, the ghetto, how to prescribe the ghetto, how to prescribe the ghetto to not have enough to live off of,
yeah.
Just below the poverty level, you know? He's mastered it on every level.
Yep.
Especially towards your jakes. Right, and enough to where you accept that and you help him kill yourself.
Yeah, man.
And the
most mainstream, the most notorious way he's killing you with the sword in mainstream media,
yep,
is by way of the cops, man.
Execution by cops.